All right, everybody. It took a little bit longer, but we finally have the draft ready. Infernal Shrines is the first map, and, well, TCM Gaming is playing versus Euronics. We are starting into the draft a bit late, as you can already tell. We have already a few of the heroes picked. Long story short, this is the consolation match in the group. TCM Gaming and Euronics are fighting for the last spot to advance out of Group A at the playoffs here. So the victor of this best of three series is going to make it. The loser is going to drop out of the tournament. The draft is rather fast here, actually, and we already jumped in a bit late because there were problems with the draft tool earlier, but as you can see, we have bans on Thrall and Falstead, so once again, we have Tyrande getting through the draft, and we end up with Euronics going for Tyrande Mirrodin. Even though the patch has already been applied, we still see Tyrande in the draft, but usually not banned out anymore, and the teams are currently in a situation where they have a bit of an easier time dealing with that stunlock composition, since Blizzard applied subtle changes to Tyrande. Infernal Shrines, of course, it's all about the AoE damage. Johanna with the Eternal Retaliation build on her Condemn is going to give you a lot of siege damage here, as does Zagara and Kel'Thas, a lot of AoE damage to get those stacks. It's also one of the reasons why TCM is currently banning out Jaina here to make sure that Euronics, first of all, can't follow up the stun on Tyrande and Mirrodin with even more damage, but also denying the Blizzard on those shrines on the temple. With me is Tetcha, and we're going to bring you not only the draft, but of course also the coverage of the game itself.
Exactly. So, Euronics, back into their pick phase now. They can take second warrior here. Leoric, for example, still incredibly good at clearing up those demons very quickly so that they can try and grab that Punisher as quick as possible. Tassadar also fitting into that as well, and a little bit extra damage, a little bit of extra sustain, just gives them a lot of options moving forward.
Yeah, and the one thing that actually surprises me a bit is that ban on Uther. It looks a bit like they are banning him out because he has that cleanse ready and also the Divine Shield. Because, like, in this case, it feels like they are more trying to just like make sure that TCM Gaming doesn't have something that can save a target they want to burst down than protect something that they need to move in. I mean, oftentimes you see a Uther with a Thrall, for example, and the whole idea is for Thrall to really go ham on the opponent, similar with Sonya as well. But in this case, it really feels like they are just trying to make sure that they can't protect that easily against Tyrande Mirrodin. And I find that Uther ban a little bit weird, to be honest. I don't think that was a necessary ban. I really feel they could have drafted this a bit better on that part, since they also don't have that immediate follow-up damage of a Jaina with the Tyrande and Mirrodin comp. TCM Gaming doesn't really seem too impressed. They go into a Karazim and a Sonya, which rounds up their lineup very nicely. I like that actually a lot. They have good damage from the back line and then also a very strong front line. So, yeah, I feel like Euronics could have maybe banned out a Sonya instead and would have been in a much better position here. But as is, we have a last pick coming in for them too, and they can adjust, of course, their own lineup a little bit here.
Yeah, they currently have Rainer as their main range damage, which is not a lot of AoE, which is kind of needed for the Infernal Shrines here. So, well, like we said before, could be Leoric, that second warrior, but they are running the double support, so that might not be as necessary here.
Yeah, I mean, right now with Tassadar and Tyrande, they have the shields. They could expect Tyrande with a bit more damage. I mean, in theory, you could with Tyrande also go for Starfall. We don't really see that talent too often anymore. If you want to go for those shrines, it might be something that would make sense if you feel that you can do without Shadowstalk. But yeah, Euronics still has a couple of options. I still think they need a bit more damage here. It feels to me like they're Thrall is banned, Sonya is taken. I really think that if they got the chance to do it, they would have picked Sonya in this case.
Yeah, I agree. Like, Sonya with a Tassadar Tyrande is very, very strong, a lot of sustain, and is just able to whirlwind on the shrines especially, just get a huge amount of damage off. And yeah, more damage, more AoE damage. Valor, good option for that, a bit of multi-shot.
Yeah, Valor could be a choice. We have, in this case, Falstead banned, so he's not an option anymore. If you really want to go for that damage, Valor is probably your best bet if you want to add some AoE as well. Then you have Mirrodin as the solo tank at the front line. I agree with that Valor pick. I mean, you already talked a bit about Leoric as an option, but I really feel if they go Leoric, they don't have the damage that they need. Valor is going to give them a little bit more control with Composite Arrow and Frost Shot then on level 13. It gives them AoE as well. So they have this double support already running. I feel Valor would be a good choice. They go for the Leoric option. I don't know, dude. I'm not a fan. I'm not a fan of the setup.
It does give them good AoE, so it's going to allow them to at least kind of compete with TCM, who's pretty much all AoE on clearing up the demons, and with March, it does give them a fair amount of damage. I'm just not sure it's enough.
Yeah, like, I would have really liked that Valor in this case here, and I feel like Tassadar Tyrande would have enough to really keep that setup alive. But as we said, we might see adjustments on the builds for Tassadar and Tyrande that make this a little bit more viable. As is, they have a very tanky setup with two tanks, two supports, one damage dealer. Of course, you can spec Tyrande and Tassadar a bit more for damage as well. But this is definitely a very a very weird lineup looking at it. TCM Gaming is playing the more solid setup here, and I'm curious to see how exactly Euronics is going to try and play, because we've seen them a couple of times playing already earlier today, and they were very aggressive and they were very strong with their lineups. So that's definitely not something where they completely screwed up. I feel like they have a plan behind this and probably played this comp before. So I'm a bit curious to see how exactly it's going to work out. The patch is new, maybe a couple of adjustments here. Infernal Shrines is the map, so without further ado, guys, let's jump in and see for ourselves. TCM Gaming versus Euronics, game number one in the best of three series. Game number one, everybody, in the best of three series has started. The consolation match in Group A of the End of the Storm playoffs here in Europe. And to the left side, we have currently Euronics, and actually TCM, sorry, with Ace of Spades on Karazim. We have Nika playing Zagara, Danatan on Johanna, Davis on Kel'Thas, and Remabala on Sonya. And to the right side of the map, with an interesting setup here, like a lineup that I actually think is a bit weird, and personally, I'm very curious to see how they are going to try and make it work. We have Kreku for Euronics on Reyna, we have Ibrahim on Taranda, Zhuv on Mirrodin, Gloohammer on Leoric, and Krolu on Tassadar. So very heavy support play that we're currently seeing on the side of Euronics, and also a double tank at the same time. Nice AoE, of course, for those shrine fights, but in team fights it feels like we are going to see a massive advantage for their opponent. But then, Euronics played some great games today, so let's see how they're going to run with this setup. With me, of course, once again is Techa, and we're going to bring you the coverage here in game number one of the best of three series between Euronics and TCM.
Yeah, both teams currently hanging in the middle as five men. We did see a tiny bit of minion block coming in there from TCM, who are immediately going on to Gloohammer here. He's taking a lot of damage, but he's tanking through it all, having to Wraithwalk away, gets a shield from Tassadar. He's able to disengage, no first blood coming in yet.
Yeah, no first blood yet, and of course the teams are starting to just move straight onto the lanes to soak experience here. Build so far, pretty much the norm. No damage specking yet on Taranda, but we could still see with this particular build that the level 1 talent Ranger's Mark move into Searing Arrows on level 4. Reanimation for Leoric. We have Johanna starting with the Condemned build, going straight into Night Takes Pawn. Eternal Retaliation is going to be the level 4 talent, since you of course want to have the cooldown reduction so that you can get the massive amount of minion damage on those shrine fights. But it's definitely an interesting setup here, and TCM looks like they have a very strong draft. I like that draft a lot, and I'm extremely curious to see how Euronics is going to try and beat it.
Yeah, I agree. It's going to be very interesting. TCM right now just playing on the aggressive, roaming between mid and bot lane. Leoric just missing that drain hope there. And with the roam between the mid and the bottom lane, actually puts TCM in a good position, seeing as that is where the first shrine is, just in that jungle. So they're going to be able to group up together and maybe make a play on it. However, Euronics are actually in position first for this.
Yeah, they're going early on into the shrine. Okay, normally in competitive play you see the teams just really trying to go for level 4 first, but in this case they go straight for the fight on it, and we have already a slight lead in the minion count. Gloohammer is missing the drain hope here, and Zagara is starting to rotate down, as is also Krolo on his Tassadar, but he is eating a lot of damage. Both of the teams nearly on level 4 now for the extra talent, and the temple of the shrine is still up, and both of them start to move in with the level 4 talents, now dropping for at first Euronics.
Yeah, Euronics were able to soak in that bottom lane to get their level 4s. Level 4s are just about to hit for TCM though, so talents will be even, but Euronics try to take their advantage to go onto Remabala, but they're not able to get him in time. Level 4s for both teams, Leoric having to back up.
Yeah, and it feels more and more like they are going to try and win this game over the objective. We have a healing ward on Taranda, which is a great talent for the map, don't get me wrong. It's just a composition that I feel it doesn't really cater to, since we are not really seeing a lot of damage for them. We have Johanna up at the front. Once again, they're going in. 34 against 28 minion stacks, and we see TCM in a bit of a better position now on the shrine itself, but it will still be the Red Punisher here, as we are seeing a nice capture by Euronics. They were just a bit faster with the damage here. They can currently capitalize on that Storm on Tassadar, of course, especially that Skeleton Swing on Leoric. So they get the Punisher. They're slightly ahead. We have Sonya moving up to the top. Eternal Retaliation has been taken as level 4 talent now too. And yeah, a very sustainable comp with healing wards, heals on Taranda, with the shields on Tassadar. Then of course again, the double tank frontline. Very, very heavy when it comes to like sustain, and it's going to be very tricky to take them down. But the question is, can they actually kill something with it?
Yeah, I couldn't agree more with all of that. Like, you have to be able to get a kill. It doesn't matter if you can get every objective. Eventually, the enemy team will kill you on the objective if you can't win the team fight. So that is what we're going to have to see for Euronics for the moment. For now, both teams just continuing to soak, wanting to get that level 7. before the next objective comes up, so they have a better chance for the fight. Okay. It was the first Punisher we saw there at that shrine, so even though Euronics were able to get it, they didn't actually get that much of a push off it, because the first Punisher isn't really that strong.
Yeah, the first one is usually easily bursted down. With the Sylvanas, you can get a bit more out of it, but in this setup, it's normally like the only thing that you get is the wall. You get the wall, which is a fair amount of experience, I mean, don't get me wrong, but if there's no Sylvanas or no late game Punisher, then the first ones can still be fought against. Nice stun here, and stun into stun, but we have, of course, Iron Skin already chosen. Level 7 talents now. Sonya dying in the top lane, apparently. Mid lane, wherever.
Don't see the Ragdoll, she died somewhere.
Not too happy about that.
Yep, David's for now just soaking up that camp, going to be getting that.
Wait a second.
To help push the top lane. What's
she
up?
Didn't
Did she die to a cab?
She can't.
I think she died to the cab that Kael Pass just got.
That could be, because I'm like, why are they laughing? And then I'm like, yeah, she could have actually died to the camp here. That is totally right.
Yeah. Like, Kael Pass was low on health. Like, maybe he could have been doing it solo, but why would he?
I mean, either way, that kill was a little bit weird. So for now, we have once again the shrine activated. It's not like too bad yet or anything, but for now, we are seeing Ramabala going straight for the Bruiser camp here. Donatan is helping out, has a Night Hick spawn. The teams are both on level 7, and a rotation to the top is actually going to start and threaten Zagara. So yeah, Zagara is currently moving back, but not pressure too much, so she's actually all right. Move back in time. We have already rapid incubation taken. And at the same time, we're now having Fission Bomb, Ferocious Healing, and yeah, everybody is starting to move into the Shrine range now and trying, of course, to get that second Punisher.
Yeah, they're taking a lot of control here right now. Pretty even on the Deeper Cast until just then. 9-4 TCM right now. I just had a quick look at the stream. Sonya died to the camp.
Yeah, I already saw that as well. But for now, let's focus on the fight here. We have, again, Gloohammer dropping in hit points and still the Shrine under control more or less of Team Euronics. They have that healing ward in the back, which is actually worth quite a lot for them, but a good flame strike takes it out already. A lot of damage taken out, but the kill against Johanna. Euronics, they get the kill and therefore the lead. We have Sonya still in play. Oh, the bombs! Zhuf is about to die. Ace is jumping and trying to take him out, but Krolu shields him in the last moment. It's a kill for a kill, and the Shrine, at least until now, under the control of TCM. It looks like they might get that second Punisher.
Not about a fight, though. Euronics coming in. They find Karazim, do a lot of damage. Ace healing himself. Gets up by Raider. Was not enough to snipe the kill. Only 5 demons needed. Ramabala trying to sneak these. The Zagara has already gone down, and that's such Ramabala has to back up. And now it's going to be Euronics trying to focus again, kiting the minions, grouping them up as much as possible. Danton coming in, but there's actually no demons left to pick up. He's one off. Can he get it? In comes Devis to try again as well. There's the Flame Strike, and that will be enough.
Yeah, that's the Punisher. They finally have it, but it's still a leading experience for Euronics, and they are hitting that level 10 ability with Shadowstalk now chosen. They have the Force Wall as well, Avatar Muradin, Hyperion Forerunner, and we're going to most likely then on level 10 see the March of the Black King, and there it is. So they have their talents. Level 10 is also going to be ready though in a second for TCM, so that they have the heroic abilities too, and there we have it. And now they can jump in and push that in and maybe get a kill with the Blessed Shield Initiation.
Nice use of the Force Wall there by Tasta to delay the extra push there. Knockback from the Raider. Blessed Shield, like you said, coming in. Raider continues to be knocked up by the Gravity Labs. Remember, Baller pushing forward, trying to get Raider. But Raider is able to kite back at the march, doing a lot of damage. But Devis able to step back. Johanna was not so lucky, already getting picked off. And a great maw from Nika, allowing the rest of TCM to escape.
Yeah, great maw here, saving them, but they still lost Johanna. And I have to give it to Euronics. This comp is currently working better for them than expected. I mean, later on, once that we have the Chain Bombs available, once that also Ramabala on his Sonya is a bit safer, thanks to Nerves of Steel and all the other talents that he can pick up there, I still feel it's going to be a bit tricky for them. But at least in the early stages of the game, they are able to just, like, fight back during those team fights a lot better than I expected. So, yeah, it's actually, at least for now, still working out.
Yeah, they are doing pretty well, in fact. Danton holding the mid lane, Sonya at the top, and the bot lane. The Khazra camp already being started by Karazim, Kael Pass, and Zagara here. They'll be able to take that pretty quickly. And the one in the jungle we just saw getting taken by the rest of Euronics, who have found Johanna roaming down from the mid lane. They're trying to go for the kill. And there is the Force Wall, though, but in comes the rest of TCM.
Yeah, Danatan once again in a bit of trouble, but gets away here. Ace of Spades could dash out. I really feel later on it's going to be a problem for Euronics when we have especially Circle of Life and Ace of Spades in 16, when we have the Brood expansion, when we have for Kalthas, for example, also the Chain Bombs and Arcane Barrier. So I feel post 16 it's really going to be a bit tricky for Euronics, but right now they are actually doing much better than I expected and are at least able to secure themselves a slight leading experience. But overall, I still stand what I said earlier, that I feel the draft was won by TCM here. So they're trying to play this, and well, let's see how exactly we are going. This fight is going to be important. This is an Arcane Punish that we're seeing here right now, and this is going to be incredibly important to see now which team is able to get a bit of a lead here.
Euronics getting a bit of a head start on the Demons. Not giving up about a fight though. Once again, a good more Nika getting dropped low. Palm was used, but Deep just expires. Nika is just now low on health. A good living bomb onto Kraku and Krona. They are backing up, trying to stay alive as Johanna pushes forward. Good forceful to zone Johanna away from the rest of her team, while Zhuv does a lot of damage in the backline.
Danatan is in general a bit too deep in a lot of these fights. Like, he's of course tempted to move in and take down the healing wards and also minions, but he's dying again, and that's 5 kills against 1. And I think it's mainly Danatan that has been dying so far for the team. So that makes it extremely uncomfortable for the rest of them. He needs to stand a little bit farther behind. Sonya already gave up on the shrine. They basically accepted that they're going to lose the Arcane Punisher, which is probably going to result in a 4 taken out. And we saw Sonya move to the top to secure some experience and make sure that they're at least not falling too far behind. But Leoric is meeting the rotation, is also going up to the top lane, as the rest of the team is now attempting to defend at the bottom of the map.
Nice dash by Ace there to get himself out of Hutton's way. Very near, he was focused down. So now the rest of TCM focusing on that Punisher, trying to get rid of it. This fort definitely going to go down, but they want to try and mitigate as much damage as possible. So the Euronics cannot really get anything else out of this. Sonya, going for round 2 on the Shaven camp, wants some revenge for a last attempt.
Yeah, let's try that again. And it looks like this time she's actually going to
Yeah,
be...
she got it.
Yeah.
Oh, hang on. Hang on. Reinforcements!
And he's not alone. There's a lot more coming.
No.
The spear!
Oh my God.
You shall not take this camp.
That camp is Sonya's kryptonite in this game.
Did you see when you checked, like, with the stream delay earlier, if the camp was actually, if the camp took down Sonya, or was it an owl that was shot cross-map to see if the camp was taken?
I didn't see any owls. I think it was the camp. Yeah. It might have been an owl, though. Yeah.
I mean, either way, like, Sonya died twice now at the same camp. And, well, TCM, they move back with Danatan again, but he had to be palmed, and that means that we have another heroic ability in cooldown. It's a really tricky spot for TCM. That sustain lineup that we're seeing here for Euronics is doing a lot more work than I thought. We have also a Shrinker, by the way, as a level 13 talent on Taranda. Not even bothering going into the overflowing web, but instead just saying like, okay, Sonya, we need something against her. I'm going to go into the Shrink Ray so that Tassadar still has the option to go into Prescience.
Yeah, I do definitely like that idea. She's getting that counter in, because they already do have the two supports on the side, both of which are able to solo anyway. Oh, this could be a mistakes were made moment. They are scouted, and the Auric is nowhere near, so they can't make a play yet, but they've at least managed to force TCM to back away from that Shaman camp.
And when it comes to damage, by the
Auric's
way, 30,000 already taken on the side of Reyna. We have 40,000 for Zagara. Kel'Thas is at 26. Has now Chain Bombs, of course, as well, which is going to help him. And there is the Shrine that has been activated. And well, we are not on level 16 yet, but level 13 is already putting a couple of interesting talents into the hands of Team TCM, and those Chain Bombs on the Shrine itself should actually help to get some damage in for Kel'Thas here, as long as he of course stays safe, but he hasn't even died in the game yet, so after this point, he's been doing a fairly good job keeping himself alive. Oh, but there's a level 16 talent now, just in time for Euronics, and that's of course like bad, bad news on the side of TCM.
Yeah, so TCM doing the smart move here. They don't know they can't fight over the objective, so they're just going for a super hard five-man push, which, well, Euronics can't really commit to. They're going for a two-man push with the mercenary count they still have while grabbing the objective as well. But TCM, they're not slowing down. They're still going for this, and as such, two members of Euronics are actually being back to base. Three members now. Four members.
It's a great decision to go for the peep now. This is the only thing that they can really do, force them back and get the level 16, and that's exactly what they do. And they get a ton of damage out of this. I mean, Leoric isn't even back. They are trying to go for it, and they can now start that fight. Good force wall here, but the fight has started, and they're going in. Circle of Life already chosen. Zagara without the Brood expansion yet. She hasn't taken the talent. Now
there
finally
it
picking it up. Leoric is still going for those minion stacks. It means that they're going to lose the keep here.
Perfectly timed Blessed Shield from Johanna, stunning Tastar just as he came out of that dimensional shift. But Tastar still able to survive there as the Avatar popped by Muradin. Leo has finally finished the punishment there, but the keep did go down in that bottom lane.
Yeah, and they're only going to get a fort in the mid lane, not more than that. So considering how this started, it actually ended very well for TCM. They went into this with a talent disadvantage fighting over a shrine. And instead, they traded now a fort for a fort and even got a keep against the Punisher now. So they're actually in a great position. As long as they're not getting taken down now, they are going to be completely fine here. The Palm is being used. Rema Baller. Wow, last second
activated. That was the last tick. Oh my god.
Yeah, that was the last tick that they were able to save this one. But yeah, they just have survived here for now. And then they're going to be fine, I suppose. They are level behind, but they are ahead when it comes to the keep.
Yeah, we are seeing Euronics try to push forwards here. Phoenix has been used by Chaos Blast to try and zone them back a bit. And with the Punisher gone, doesn't look like Euronics are that willing. Great forceful. Sonya going maybe a bit too greedy while our team was trapped. Was trying to slow down the retreat of Euronics so they can try and go for a kill. Krolu, dimensional warp, getting out of there with the extra movement speed he gets from that. And the forceful to make sure there is no extra chase.
And now we have the level 16 talents, and with 16, I feel this is going to be a very interesting time for Euronics, because that's when I really thought that we would see a slight lead on the side of TCM. But let's see how TCM is actually going to play with those 16 talents. That should help them. I mean, they have a lot of damage now on the side of most of their heroes, or a ton of sustain that helps them in these battles. So at the same time, they keep at the bot lane dying. That was a problem. We have Reyna with now also Bullseye after double barrel, True Shot Aura for Tyrande. And especially in the case of the Rude Swing for Leoric after going for Ghastly Reach, that's working out for them too. Oh, look at that. This time she actually took a few reinforcements. All right, third time's the charm.
Yeah. She's not even being the one to finish it. It's like bad things happened when I tried to take that camp. Just gonna let my team do it.
Let's move back. Let's talk about this a bit later.
Oh, didn't need to worry though, just the fact. Euronics, bot lane, stealing the Khazra camp. They were scouted, but a little bit too late. Nothing that TCM can do about that. However, they are moving in here. Zuf is here. Needs to be careful and not get caught out. Oh, nice
jump.
Toss.
Good timing, but that's not all there is. And he gets... Oh, no. This is looking bad. Avatar, stone form used. Had to use both of it. Moves back. Phoenix zones very well now. And Zuf popped the Avatar, so that's in cooldown. Shrine is active on the map again. And that's a battle that I definitely want to see. This is going to be a very interesting shrine battle. But I have to give some credit here to Euronics. I have to admit that after seeing the draft, I did not think that they would be able to contest this at all. And they are playing a great game here. They're just showcasing once again, which they have done several times today, that they are a super solid team. And I really, I find it super interesting what's happening here. I like that. The line is much better than I thought it would be.
Yeah, and Euronics have actually been doing a really good job here of doing the correct thing, which is waiting for their level 20s as much as possible. There is an objective, so they now kind of have to sort of fight, but you can see they're not committing. They're just staying in poke range, waiting for someone to make a mistake and overextend. They're actually having to back up here, spreading the chain bomb in the process, but they are just being very careful. They want that level 20 before they fight, but they don't seem to have much of a choice here.
Yeah, and once again, Chain Bombs in play, March of the Black King used, Divine Palm on Rama Baller, not triggered though, they move in again, and these Force Walls the entire time trying to trap heroes here, they're moving in once again, 29 versus 13 minion stacks, Danatan is low, gets healed by Ace, good job by Karazim, and again, Kel'Thas of course trying to go for the Chain Bombs here, waiting for the cooldown to get ready, Nika is done, so is Kel'Thas, down goes Sagara, they're going for the next kill here, Chain Bombs everywhere, but we have the Kel'Thas kill as well. It's a double kill against them. And that massive amount of sustain is working out really nicely for them. They even take down Karazim now. They just don't die.
They have level 20 as well. The only threat they have right now is their core is actually under attack, but Minion Wave will spawn to delay that. And Leoric has beat back to clear this as quick as he can so he can rejoin his team and push.
Look at these level 20 talents. They are never going to die. It's a double Storm Shield now, an Escape on Reyna, Spectral Leech for Leoric, and a Hardened Shield. Like, they already have double Warrior, double Support. They are never gonna die. It's just not gonna happen.
Yeah, it's gonna be really difficult for Euronics to actually get any kills. To get kills here. TCM, they are gonna have to seriously just soak for level 20. For now, they have to focus on killing that Punisher. Because Euronics are not sending the entire team to attack here, because Tastar has to clear that Shaman camp in the top lane.
Yeah, Tassadar is now starting to move in, looking at the damage once again to give you a bit of an update. I mean, Reyna at 55,000 is still doing a very solid job, but we have at least Kel'Thas and Zagara both catching up now, so they are able to get a lot more damage out. But especially against the Chain Bombs, it's going to be so great for them to have that Storm Shield here on two of the heroes. It's going to be incredible. Without a level 20 talent, TCM can't really fight here. And again, oh, that Divine Palm last moment save again for Danatan here. Again, of course, that Force Wall everywhere. Chain Bombs are being used right now. Oh, Ace dashes away. Zhuv is affected by another Chain Bomb. They lost the keep. Well, they're about to, but the level 20 talent isn't ready yet. And they're starting to push Euronics back a bit.
Yeah, Euronics having to retreat here. The Chain Bombs doing a great job, but they're actually spreading them quite a lot. Taking a lot of damage. There's the knock up onto Tastar, but they decide not to dive in here. But the fact that TCM are soaking up, they still haven't got their level 20s, and that is what is forcing Euronics to back up, because they can't take the risk of level 20 being hit mid-fight while TCM has more health. But here we go, they're actually going to go in and try and get a pick before that 20 happens. Going on to Kael'thas, but the Arcane Barrier is popped. Kael'thas does go down, though, so no more Chain Bombs, which is what's been saving them in this fight.
Devis, unfortunately, with a bit of a bad positioning here, goes down. They go for Rammer Ball, and now Peaceful Reposal has been used. And, well, you have to also... Oh, indestructible here, but the double kill against not only Sonya, but also early on Kael'thas. And now it's a 5 versus 3 again. And Euronics, they don't stop there. They try to go for Ace, but he dashes out of the fight. Gloohammer moves in once more. But it's an attempt for the core. At least they're talking about it, but they decide to move away for now. Back in the back in the back of the fight, we have currently Healing Ward building, helping them out a bit more. But now level 20 versus level 20 talents, and this is actually a very a weird game. I mean, this is kind of 11 kills against one the earlier keep taken, but it looks really like Euronics is going to bring this over the time. They are looking amazing here now. They have a shrine at the top, and again, they just don't die.
Yeah, and there's a Sonya still dead for 20 seconds. She'll be up just as the shrine is spawning. But the odds are Euronics, the second it has spawned, will be on it and clearing up the demons as quick as possible, giving themselves a huge advantage.
I mean, look at the damage output here that we have on their side. 73,000 on Kael'thas, 86,000 on Zagara. And the only hero that is above 40,000 hero damage on the side of Euronics is Reyna. Nobody else. Yeah. And we are talking about 11 kills versus 1. And that one kill was Leoric, and he doesn't really care. Because we all know that Loki is always going to come back. So, like, with now also those 20 talents, this is just getting crazy.
Yeah, it's very interesting. Here comes TCM, though. This is may end up, in fact, being the last fight of the game. Sonya, like we said, she spawned in time. A huge head start has been attained by Euronics here. Chain Bombs being applied to Krolu, but he's not spreading them this time. And Donatan needs to be careful. Rammer Baller going in very deep here. It's much damage. Good force will zone out the rest of the team, and the Storm Shield is doing a great job of the protection. But so far, no deaths, more only hitting. The Tirana, but Danatan getting focused down. The Palm has been used. It does get popped here. Rammer Baller having to back up again, and Danatan indestructible. He's still not dead. But the team is so split up here, they need to be a bit more careful. Danatan getting killed off thanks to the bolt from Kraku, but Kraku's gone very deep here, getting focused down. He is healing thanks to his own trait. He's trying to turn the fight out from downtown. Kraku gets living bombed. Demis bolts away, but Kraku still lives and continues to do damage. It was a 2-0 in favor of Euronics here, and they're moving back onto the objective. There are mercenaries on the core of TCM, and the Punisher has been taken.
They just don't die. I mean, even when he finally was about to die to the bomb and everything else, they just pop a couple of shields and he survives, and now they lock Ace out. Oh my god! The Ragdoll is just getting pumped throughout the entire map. Unbelievable. Euronics 14 kills against one, and that draft that they have here, it's like, they are the indestructibles, the untouchables. They just don't die. It's impossible to kill them. 14 kills against one. The damage output on, like, Zagara alone is 107,000. Kael'thas is at 88,000. And they just don't care. Leoric by now is also doing solid damage, by the way. Like, this game, crazy.
Yeah, I'd like to give a big shout out to Leoric this game. His drains have been on point, really working on those tanks. They're moving on to the core. The Chain Bombs are down. A lot of damage being done, but it's not going to be enough. That will be GG. And we will see Euronics take the lead in the best of three series.
Well played. Great game. And yeah, they take the 1-0, and we're going to jump into game number 2 to see who is going to win the next one. All right, everybody, the draft for game number two has started, and we are on Sky Temple. Sky Temple is going to be the next map, and TCM Gaming is going up against Euronics. So we have Muradin banned out and Kalthas as well. TCM, well, they played him in the last game and weren't really successful with him, but they said, okay, we don't want to go up against him either. So, yeah, Tyrande once again, an optional, of course. Muradin banned out here too. So the patch was really subtle, but it definitely shook up the meta slightly, at least, and Tyrande is not really as highly prioritized anymore as she was before. Euronics is currently ahead, of course, after that first game that we just saw, and TCM, they have to win on Sky Temple or they are out of the tournament, and Euronics would advance together with NaVi and with Tetcha, again, bringing you the coverage here, and of course, first of all, the draft.
I do need the link for that.
Oh. Dude, like, I have the perfect setup here and you screw it up by not having the link. How dare you?
I know, I feel terrible.
And so you should. All right, I'm going to give you that link real quick and then you can maybe participate in the draft as well. Guess who's
Thank
being
you.
Picked first? Of course, it is a Thrall. So with the
who
Thrall
saw
first
that
pick.
Coming?
Yeah, we didn't saw that coming at all. So with the Thrall first pick, we're currently looking at possibly a Tyrande comp again. I mean, Tyrande ETC could still be played here for TCM. I mean, you can shake it up as well if you want to have something completely different. We're also talking about, of course, a potential Jaina here, which at least gives you a little bit of, like, burst damage here. So, yeah, after that last game, I'm very interested to see how TCM Gaming is going to start that draft off. And they start, actually, with that Zagara again, which they already picked on the last map.
Yeah, they are, in fact, bringing the Tyrande like you did predict. And I once again have a delay on what the next pick is.
Well, right now, let's see. We have actually, in this case, Euronics, of course, with a double pick. For Euronics, it's interesting because, again, they could go into the tanks at the front first. We have still a couple of supports around that they could both take, even if, for example, an Uther is banned out, they have access to a Charism. So don't really think that they're going to be too worried about that. They can go into the range damage at this point. Falstad is still available. We have also, of course, Reyna, who can be taken, which they already took earlier. So yeah, I think we're definitely gonna see at least one range damage hero and probably like a frontliner taken for Euronics at this point.
Yeah, Tassadar's still open as well, and he has been pretty much dominating in every game he's been in today. Like, Tassadar has been really on point in terms of everything.
Yeah, definitely true. There's a Falstad that I just mentioned, so Falstad is definitely being played. Yeah. As you said, Tassadar is also a great choice, especially since, of course, Zagara is on the other side of the map, so that really helps. Then, of course, you have to always answer the question, do you play Tassadar solo? Do you try to just, like, get something else in there as well? And, yeah, Tassadar could be taken or even banned at some point, but Euronics, this is probably, like, one of the questions that's on their mind right now. They know that after this pick, the bans are coming in, so they need to make a decision right now. Tassadar is definitely an option that they have. They could go into a frontliner, too, if they wanted to, try to pick something away from Tyrande, secure themselves, for example, in ETC. But they go for the Uther. They want to have that Divine Shield with Thrall this time. And, of course, also the cleanse against the potential Tyrande Comet combo. Especially, of course, since there is the potential to go into a Jaina depending on what Euronics wants to ban.
Yeah, very true. It makes a lot of sense picking up that Uther. Plus, Divine Shield on Thrall, just if they want to go on the aggressive, is still going to be very effective as well. TCM bans, currently Euronics yet to pick their warrior, but so are TCM, so they need to be careful what they are banning out so that they don't limit their own options. They could also ban out maybe a bit more range damage and hope that they do still get the Jaina.
I mean, you can always argue, of course, ETC as well, if you think about it.
Yeah.
It depends on what TCM Gaming wants to take here. For them, ETC would also make sense since they have Zagara and Tyrande. Both of them could really capitalize off a good mosh pit, or ETC can move in after a maw. But if they don't plan on playing with ETC, they should probably ban him out, because then Euronics would be happy to take him. They have the Uther already for Divine Shield on Thrall, but having the extra option of putting it on the ETC for the mosh pit instead is always great as well. So for me personally, if they don't ban him out now, they probably plan on taking ETC themselves. And for Euronics, I would probably recommend that Jaina ban.
These are quite likely. My draft appears to be bugging slightly because it shows there's 0 seconds left for both teams, but there is that Reyna ban.
It has that occasional delay, that's normal. Reyna ban and Sonya ban. So Jaina and ETC are both available. That's actually, like, for both of the teams, very solid.
Yeah.
TCM
so Jaina
could take both.
They could. ETC Tyrande is still a stun combo, and then throw Jaina on top for that burst damage. Still definitely good potential there.
Yeah, the Tassadar is of course still around, so TCM could say, okay, we play Tirana Tassadar now. The Jaina is taken. Doesn't really surprise me. I really thought that Euronics would ban her out, but Sonya has been played a lot. And they go Diablo over ETC, which allows Euronics to go ETC. And now it's kind of surprising to me that they did. I mean, Diablo works perfectly with Tirana, and Diablo, Tirana, Jaina is of course like nasty as hell because you get that stun comp in and you just like get all that damage. But then I would probably have still gone into a ban on ETC in if I was in the shoes of TCM Gaming. Euronics, I mean, they could go Johanna here. I personally like ETC in this setup quite a bit. They have the Uther, which can suddenly give Divine Shields to anyone there. He has also later on that cleanse that he can use to make sure that that comp is not doing too much of a DAS ETC. So I like that already. And at this point, they can just basically think about what they want to play here. If they want to have another frontliner and play it with a double tank again, plus that melee assassin that they have, if they want to do for a bit of range damage with a Vala, for example, that they could still take here. So they have a very nice core setup already, I feel.
Yeah, the beginning of their setup looks very strong. It's just a question of how they want to finish it off. Another frontline, extra range damage. All options, like we said, range damage is no, it's going to be Tassadar. So Tassadar, we've been talking about it for a while.
Not something that you see too often.
Yeah, it's very weird. Thrall is not going to die.
Yeah.
And a Nubarak. I like this. I like this a lot.
Anubarak is actually played in scrims a lot these days, and I love it because we see Webblast coming in again. Was it called now Cocoon or Webblast? I always forget. I think it's Cocoon now, right? Yeah, Webblast was the former name of the talent. But yeah, so that's actually like pretty sweet. I like this. TCM, yeah, that's actually a very fun lineup. But again, Euronics is going for this we cannot die composition. So let's see if TCM Gaming can actually take them down this time. Jumping to the game number two, ladies and gentlemen, Sky Temple. Euronics is in the lead. And let's find out if TCM can take this game and force map number three of Euronics is going to take it with a 2-0. Game number two is live, and we have Sky Temple. To the left side of the map, we have TCM, and they're currently down in the best of three series here at the consolation match of the End of the Storm, a playoff group A. Ace of Spades on Tirana this time, Rimmer Baller on a Nubarak. We have Danatan on Diablo, Devis on Jaina, and Inika on Zagara. To the right side of the map, the Polish team, though, Euronics with the lead after this pretty impressive Infernal Shrines game that we saw on the first map. Zhuv on Tassadar, Gluhammer on ETC, Kreku on Falstad. We have Krollo and Uther, so again a double support comp, and Uberim is playing Thrall. So pretty interesting setup once again. Normally when you see a Tassadar, he's either comboed off with a Tyranda or with a Brightwing. Haven't really seen him comboed off too much with an Uther or like one of those heavy healers. So this is going to be one of those setups again that is of course dedicated to keep the team members alive. But there's also a lot of zoning on the side of the opponent. But again, Diablo being attacked, and Danatan dies. Yeah. Face checking that bush did not really help. Gluhammer is ready for the slide. And yeah, I don't know, Tetra. That's once again a pretty good start for Euronics here into the match.
Yeah, Euronics definitely seem to be, in pretty much all the games they played, very good at getting the first couple kills, or at least getting first blood. They're very good at that lockdown kill.
Yeah, and well, for now we have a Rimmer Baller up at the top here. Let's see here. Krollo, Kreku, everyone. Oh, they slide in again for the potential kill. And...
Oh, really?
Oh my god. They kill him through the wall. It's kill number two. And that is definitely not how you want to start a game when you're already down one map in the best of three series. TCM is definitely feeling the pressure now.
Just when you thought you were safe. Suddenly, in comes ETC and Uther. For now, Shrine's going to be coming up. Skara has pushed that bottom lane up quite aggressively. Will she stay down there and soak XP? And will Thrall stay down there to counter Soaker? Or will he come up to help out with that middle Shrine? Because right now, TCM beginning to group up. It looks like they want to try and contest the middle Shrine. The top one, they are just giving over. ETC getting focused down, and that's a lot of Suns. But Suns his own way out, and he's going to get away.
You think about it, like, if we have the early game kills on the side of the Polish team, Euronics is getting the kills, whereas the entire burst composition has been drafted by TCM. Of course, it's going to get a bit stronger than later on as well, but right now, I don't really think that they're going to be happy with this. They are the ones who are trying to go for stun into stun, and they have the extra stuns with the Nubarak as well to open that up, and now they might finally get one against Krollo here, but no, they don't. They just
so
don't get their
and
kills,
shields.
And Ace is really low.
Yeah, the heals and the shields, really effective here from the Uther Tastar combo, just so hard to kill people. And yeah, as we've seen, they still do enough damage. This might be a bit greedy though, going very deep. Kraku using his barrel roll to get out, and he still lives. They're turning it up to Danitan. Danitan just gets out of there. But Euronics just showing so much domination in this game.
They are more than a level ahead. They are more than a level ahead. ETC was soaking most of the shots in the mid lane, actually. They went through the entire wall here, so they got the shots in the mid lane. They fought with three up here at the top. Now they're nearly two level ahead at this point. I don't even know what to say anymore. This is crazy.
Yeah, even in the bot lane, Thrall has actually managed to out-trade Zagara at some point that's taking control of this lane as well. A huge roam's coming down, and Thrall realizes he's made a horrible decision, so he's going to chase Zagara. But four versus one, that was bound to happen in the end, and Thrall does get taken down. And that is the first kill on the board for TCM.
It's the first kill, but we have level 4 talents in now. We have shields everywhere. I mean, Uther with the protective shield, then of course Leeching Plasma taken for Tassadar. They're pushing them back again. They have the level 7 talents. They're 1.5 levels ahead. We could end up in a scenario where level 10 drops way before TCM gets it, once that the shrine at the bot lane is up.
Yeah, and that would be huge for Euronics. And they are just continuing to soak for the moment, just getting as much XP as possible. They push top lane to the point where they can't even soak in it anymore without the risk of being ganked. So they're just roaming around looking for people to pick. Dev is very close there. Al will see that this camp is under serious duress, but there's nothing that TCM can do about it.
Follow through for Thrall, cleanse for Uther. There's no way that you contest these talents at this point. And they are just moving through the map once again. I can't still believe that they held the top lane with three heroes against four, were able to push them back, nearly got a kill, and during all of this had the soak going on in the mid lane. Zhuv, on the other hand, gets stunned now, but there is still Krolu around, so he can really help out too. Doesn't even have to pop the cleanse, and why would he? He has still those heals up. We have Thrall now rotating up to the top, where he's now finally starting to take a couple of the camps, especially, of course, the Bruiser camp here. And with still a a level lead, at least in talents, we are seeing TCM catching up, starting to get now that level 7 talent with Urticating Spines after Legion of Beetles. Bit of a hybrid build that we see here for Everborn now.
Yeah, he's got a bit of clear, just the area damage around him, and of course the extra beetle is going to allow him to control the lanes a little bit better. Bit of a scuffle in the top lane. Diablo once again getting rooted by Thrall, and he's going to get taken down again. Walking through the healing wall though, uses Uther as a dash to basically get out of there. There's the slow from Data, and that's going to be enough. Very nice save there. Ubereve, he's not done, but he only drops the lightning, did not have the Feral Wolf on cooldown.
Very nice escape here by Danatan. I mean, that was pretty solid what he did there. So getting away in this situation was very cool, very well done as well. The interesting part for me also is that we still have Rapid Incubation taken on the side of Nika. He's one of the few players that I actually know in Zagara that constantly goes for Rapid Incubation here, no matter the map or the game situation. He really prefers that build, whereas most players would go for Endless Creep or instead draw Battle Momentum here. But it's a great talent. We've been talking about it a bit earlier. It can be very, very nice to give you the lane sustain. Thrall in a bit of trouble in the mid lane, but he escapes, and the bot lane is of course still soaked. That's a temple that we see there, which gives us level 10 very, very early for the team in red. And I mean, this is like nightmare scenario for TCM what we're seeing here.
Yeah, TCM just in serious trouble. There's nothing they can do to contest this bottom temple until they have level 10, and that's still a full level away. So in the meantime, while bottom 4 is just getting annihilated, four members of Euronics here are just going to come in and push this mid lane. And well, TCM, they can come up and contest this, and they will have a 4 versus 5 situation, so that is what they're going to do. But Zagara had to go B to get some health.
And ETC is also now on the way up to the top, and we have Mosh Pit, Force Wall, Mighty Gust, Divine Shield, and Sundering. They're going through the structures, and I mean, with every single structure that you take down, the next temples that you capture are going to be so much more dangerous to your opponent, because they are starting to attack the inner circle. All of the forts are eliminated except for the one at the bot lane. They go for boss, and why not? I mean, the owl is there, but without the level 10, there's no way to contest it, even
they're
with
gonna
the
get
owl.
It, though.
Even with the owl, it's going to be tricky with the Mighty Gust and everything else. There's the level 10. That Euronics, they lost
Cocoon.
The game earlier because of this. Can they take the boss? Where is that Mighty Gust? There it is. The Force Wall works against them. They go for the boss. They get it. They take the boss and they have claimed it. But are they going to keep the heroes alive?
The Mosh Pit interrupted by the more there. Divine Shield was already used. And Euronics actually getting crushed here. Krolu gets shielded by Tassadar, gets knocked up, and he will go down. Two kills coming in from TCM, but the boss was taken, and that is goodbye to the fort in the bottom lane. And that is all three forts down for TCM. And Euronics only losing two heroes for this, and they're just continuing to take control. Doesn't matter they have heroes dead, because TCM have to go to bot lane to defend.
Yeah, they could have even been better, but the Tassadar Force Wall actually worked against them because they pushed the hero only in the Force Wall instead of away. So it's an early boss, it doesn't really do as much damage, but it allows them to move on the map, push the lanes back, and yeah, get a bit of soak going. So it's still 11 versus 12, an entire level advantage that we see for Euronics. You can argue about how that boss fight went, but in the end, they are still ahead. They took all of the forts down. Temples, if they can catch them, are going to attack the keeps right away now. It's a great position for them to be in still, and they will, of course, also hit that level 13 faster. And if they hurry, they might even be able to get that during those temple fights.
And that is the aim they're going to try and go for here. Temples are up 13, not available as of yet for Euronics. They were not able to soak it. But they still do have a level advantage, so they're just hanging around the mid-temple for now. It's not like they want to fight yet. There is the Shadowstalk there used by Taronda. And yeah, we just see Euronics not wanting to bother. They don't need to, because they're so close to level 13, so they're just running pop. They're going to grab the shots from that instead, because like you said, it's already going to the inner circle.
Yeah, and it's also like, why would you fight if you don't have the level 13 talent if you are so far ahead that you know you're going to hit it first if you just dodge that battle for a bit longer? So now they have Prescience, Giant Killer, we have Uther with also the Shrink Ray, and they are starting to pressure the bot lane, keeping that forces heroes off the mid lane, of course. So it's a great position for them, and they are trying to exploit it as much as they can. But of course, we are seeing TCM on level 13 in just a bit as well. They already soaked all of the shots in the middle.
Yes, so TCM are going to be able to hang around this area to defend. They're getting quite close to their level 13s themselves here. So in theory, they could go for a fight faster, grabbing the lost shots from bot lane, will now move up, grab a Phantom and move up to help his team in case that a scuffle does break out.
Yeah, the bot lane already, that first keep has suffered some damage. 13 versus 13, now maybe that's the chance for TCM to turn around. Overflowing light, we're seeing Firestorm after Fire Devil taken. And on at the same time now also Burning Rage, we have the improved Ice Block, Frostbitten on level 7 for Jaina after the Snowstorm on 4. Rotation around to the bot lane, going for one of the forts here. And we have everybody on the side of the Polish team starting to move down to the bottom lane to contest it. They want to fight here.
Roll's a little far out though, they need to be a bit careful as to how quickly they engage. Roll now arriving, and they just weren't reacting quick enough. They're still protecting their forts though. Like, TCM are doing all this roaming, but they're not actually getting the forts for it. They're only damaging them and working them down. But an objective will soon spawn, and that, if they can get control, will be able to take down the forts. But it's still shots that aren't going onto the inner circle.
It's also a very different situation now in the game itself. At the beginning, it was really that roaming and the movements on the map that put Euronics ahead. But now we are in the mid-game where we have the heroic abilities ready. And we didn't really see an honest team fight yet. We had that fight over the boss, but that doesn't really count since, of course, we had Euronics focus on the boss quite a bit. But now in that team fight scenario that we're seeing between the two teams, TCM could really start to combo their abilities off in a way that they get a bit of a wombo combo potential here. The same is of course also true with that wash pit that we have. So it's going to be incredibly interesting to see how this is going to work out for the two teams once that they really face each other in a 5 versus 5 battle on the map.
Yeah, more Apoc Ring is an insane wombo combo that TCM could get if they just get an advantageous position. This is why Euronics have been so cautious about when it comes to fight, because they're very much relying on ETC or Thrall to set up their engagement here.
Yeah, Falset is, by the way, currently at the bottom of the map. He's not flying in for anything. The rotation of TCM is very nice. He's starting to move in here and they start to take down another fort. That really helps them. Temples are going to be active in a bit, but we have again the move down to the bot lane, capturing one of the camps and maybe even going for the fort itself, whereas ETC is going to start soaking the top lane now.
Yeah, exactly. Euronics just going to let their bot fort go and going to soak the top lane. Not sure about they want to fight the mid lane yet. They're just using the advantage that they already have and just avoiding the fight as much as possible at this point.
Yeah, here comes
TCM. TCM really want to fight.
Yeah, they really do, but we have an immediate Mighty Gust making sure that that doesn't happen anytime soon. Bot lane, though, pretty big wave coming in against that fort, and we still have also those two mercenaries here, and that's what's being deep pushed. And you can really tell that Euronics doesn't fight right now. They don't want to. They want to go for level 16 first, and I have no idea what ETC is doing there. I have no idea what that was.
He does have his dash, and Uther is near him for maybe a Divine Shield or a Cleanse, but no, Uther gets mauled here, and this is terrible for Euronics. Down goes ETC. Uther gets caught in the APOC, and he gets taken down before Divine Shield. I have no idea why they did that.
That was a massive mistake on their part here. ETC moving way too fine. They even had division and everything. Like, they just sacrificed two heroes for no reason whatsoever. There was nothing to gain. Nothing to gain. The vision on the heroes at the bot lane that were trying to save the fort was there. So there, at no point was there a situation where TCM said, like, okay, we have to back off here. They might all move into the temple right now. They knew that half the team was at the bottom lane. Now it's level 16 versus 16. That experience is completely gone.
Yeah, TCM just using their opportunity to grab the boss, but Euronics use this chance to go straight for the temples. It is Tassadar and Falstad here. Going to be very hard to pick them off. Mental Shift used straight away. There's the Mighty Gust. Tassadar, though, getting chased. He force walled everyone else away, so it's only a Anuvarak chasing him here. And Tassadar will be able to escape. And Thrall is able to grab all the shots from the top lane, so they're not too bad for here for Euronics. They're still even on XP, even after losing those heroes. But they now have to defend against the boss, while TCM are moving up to the top lane to take advantage of their position.
Yeah, and TCM is actually the team that is starting to threaten to take the first keep here. They already go through the wall. They are ahead in experience right now, and this is only going to increase the more structures they are able to take down here. They're in a very solid situation now, even after level 10 hit. There was just nothing anymore that Euronics was able to do in those team fights. There was nothing really happening. After level 10, you could really tell that things were changing in favor of TCM, especially, of course, with that small mistake at the top. Or actually, it was pretty big mistake, losing two heroes and gaining nothing in return. So it's a very tricky situation at this point for Euronics, and it looks very much like they are trying to just like find an opportunity to maybe sneak past the opponent, get a bit of damage in against the structure, steal a camp away, or get a sneaky kill.
I think they were trying to actually just get an ambush on that easy camp, because that's what they thought they were, both teams actually. Just looking for a sneak in, like they both think the other one's there, but no. TCM now showing in the top lane, and immediate ports coming in from Euronics, except for ETC, who's sneaking around behind so that they can maybe get a mosh, but he needs to not get caught out here.
Yeah, he can't, and I'm very, very much afraid of for them at this point. Like, they have the problem that no matter what they do, they are always the ones that are starting to react. The entire early game was them dominating the decisions, them moving in, them making, like, something happen, taking a camp, catching a Campbell, sniping a hero, getting a little bit ahead, and just, like, having the initiative on the map. And right now, the entire situation has changed. We have TCM making the moves on the map and just, like, being in the active role, kind of dominating what's happening here, whereas Euronics is just reacting and trying to somehow outplay them, but it doesn't work out for them anymore.
Yeah, there's very little they can do about this for now. Euronics just going to be moving down to that temple, and it looks like they're just going to set that up as their defensive position. However, TCM not having any of it. Moving up to the top lane, they're just going to get the push. Tassadar has sort of made the space a Protoss one and has set up some pre-shielding there. But Euronics having to be back to base straight away because they realize they're in a lot of danger here.
Yeah, and this keep is gone. I mean, even with the Mighty Gust, this keep is gone. One, two spells, and that's about it.
Yep, it's dead.
But the bot lane, on the other hand, has also been eliminated, so at least the temple was able to snipe a few of the structures, and they are just continuing with the middle right now. So it is actually kind of close at this point. A bit closer than it has to, but still, like, it's not like Euronics are super far behind or anything. They are the ones to actually put a lot of pressure now into the mid lane as well. They might just not kill the one. It's going to live. Oh, they actually moved back before the entire
thing. Oh, wow. I thought it was charging up the last five shots.
Yeah, me too. Like, they could have actually killed it, but they were afraid that they would lose a hero as a result.
A fair decision. Then I agree thoroughly with that. And for now, though, we're going to see TCM. They're going to move in, and they will steal the shots from that temple. Whereas the rest of the team moving up to grab that bruiser camp. Tassadar, once again, has been doing a great job setting up shields to delay this and just make sure that the temples do not get the maximum efficiency.
This is a very, very tactical game right now. I mean, both of the teams, like, first of all, of course, TCM would really like the team fight. They say, hey, we have the stronger team fight right now, we want to go for it. And at the same time, you can really tell how we're having the exact opposite on the side of Euronics. I actually think that with Epic Mount as a level 20 talent on Falstad, we might see them just try to play around the opponent and somehow win that game, maybe sneaking in, attacking the core with Falstad, making a move there, or just moving in somewhere, taking a temple. They might try to use the mobility of him on the map, because that's something that TCM just doesn't have.
Yeah, right. like, Euronics are just ridiculously scared of TCM's Wombo Combo right now, so they've been avoiding fights at whatever the cost. So I definitely agree with you. The extra mobility is going to be huge for them, because it'll allow them to play around TCM and maybe make a backdooring attempt or something similar. TCM, they know they have the control there. They're taking the risk and moving into that bottom keep. However, Gloohammer coming in from the side, looking for his opportunity. Mighty Gust is used. ETC does go in, but not able to get him. Do we see the cocoon? No, they're not going to take that risk.
Yeah, he was realizing that he could not trap all three or all four of them that he needed. I mean, we have the interrupt on, well, we have four heroes actually that can interrupt the mosh pit, and he just realized that he wasn't able to get like them clogged up like he wanted to, so he moved back, played it safe. Boss is being attacked on the other hand, and that is a massive risk. With the level 20s taken, Lord of Terror, Hardened Shield, Rewind, and Bolt of the Storm, here comes that fight, and oh my god, this, like, even if... Oh, he goes on the form, he takes the mosh pit, he goes for it, this could be it, they steal the boss away, they actually have it. Here comes the Apocalypse in the backline, we already have Cocoon used. They try to snipe, they go for the kill against ETC. Uther's down as well. He's gonna be back, of course. Mighty Gust has been used, and now the boss has to be defended against. But there's two temples on the map. There is two temples. The boss goes straight for the core. This is the chance for Euronics to off to take it.
Euronics, even with a hero down, are just rushing straight for the temples here. They're just going to get a huge amount of damage on the keep in the mid lane. Is completely doomed. The top lane does have a fountain to tank it, but there's a contestant at the middle shrine, and we're going to see Uberim get taken down, and this is really bad timing for this.
This is exceptionally bad timing, and now, of course, the shots are being fired here again. The boss is already on the core, but down to half HP, level 20s for both, and the top temple is just now starting to attack the keep. They get the first one, but we have Tacita being attacked now as well. They're trying to move around him. He's not able to take one of the keeps down. The core is currently at 78%, 70% still going for it. Again, the wind tunnel being used here. The core is at 61%, but the keep in the mid lane is now eliminated, and it's about to lose the keep at the bot lane too. This game is getting out of hand.
Both temples are active in favor of TCM. The bottom lane keep is going to die as well. They're expecting TCM to move in for the kill here, but that is this temple going straight onto the core. It doesn't have that many shots left though, so it looks like the core will survive with its shield intact, but their core is now completely exposed. TCM's base though, their keeps are pretty much made out of paper mache, so they will die at the slightest breeze.
this is getting really nasty now. Boss call there, oh my god, like the boss steal that first of all, and then losing of course the heroes in the mid lane when they were going for them. They could have theoretically ended the game.
Yeah,
there.
They followed the boss. I quite like that.
Well, actually, yeah, well, either that or just with five man, go for those. Uh-oh, Apocalypse already used. Camp is taken. It's a 5v5 once again. Uberim is moving in. And the mosh pit fail. Uh-oh, Gloohammer.
He's used his bolt. There we go. He does the extra rage at the wind tunnel for disengage. Euronics will live to fight another day. They do need to head top, though, because that is a pretty big minion wave. And mid is about to suffer the same treatment.
And Wind Tunnel is just showing again how much they want to disengage from these battles, that they don't, how much they want to dodge those team fights. Epic Mount would have been pretty solid as well, of course, with that mobility on the map, but yeah, this is starting. It still feels like it's TCM's game to lose.
Yeah, well, TCM need to win this game, because if they lose, then they're out. They're already 0-1 down. They need to be able to take this game to be in with a chance of moving on to the round of 8. So they're putting everything they have into this. They have a Bruiser camp. They have a minion wave. They're about to maybe make their last play. They've been seen by Tassadar though.
Techa, the next temple is going to be ending the game. There's two temples. Double temple. All that they need is one temple. And that's TCM. And on the side of... I guess a temple could actually be enough. I mean, looking at the structures, there's a tower.
I think mid is too much... There's
60% on the core.
Yeah, this is true. Well, maybe they could just make the play on the core. Right now, it looks like Tacitar and ETC making their way to the mid.
Falstead is webbed at the bottom. They go for him. There's the stun. Falstead is dead. Temple in the middle is being taken. And, oh god, Thrall moves
in. He's going for a solo on the core. He can't do this.
They have a temple as well, if they get it. But there's Diablo all of a sudden.
Diablo's tank, you get doing the damage. Uther's Divine Shield himself delaying it, but so many heroes have gone back. Tazadar coming in to help Thrall. Where's the shield? There it is, trying to help him tank, but it's not enough. Huge amounts of burst coming onto him. Uther is still fighting Zagara in the bot lane, and Diablo still fighting ETC in the mid lane. Uther survived in the bot lane. He's taking more of the temple, and it's going to go onto the keep. But Zagara is heading for the core because mid has been taken by Diablo, and that is going to be GG. And TCM brings the score to 1-1.
What a game. A 1-1, a tie in the series, and it is over. What a weird game on Sky Temple.
Yeah.
And we're going to go into game number 3. Towers of Doom, game number 3. We have Towers again. I love it. Euronics, they lost the last game. The series is tied. TCM Gaming versus Euronics. And again, the map choice of Euronics, the Polish team, they go for Towers of Doom. They played an amazing game against NaVi earlier. They lost it in the end. And now the draft starts. And we have Thrall being banned out immediately and Fawcett as well. Like, bam, bam. Not even thinking about it. The teams know exactly what they want to get rid of. That leaves Kel'Thas in the game. That leaves Tyrande in the game. And, well, of course, also that Tyrande-Tassadar composition that we've seen. We had Euronics with very interesting setups, actually. They like to play with the ETC, for example. They have to go up against the Kel'Thas now at this point, but they start things again with the Mirrodin. They can go into the Tyrande. They do that. So they have the start of a sniper composition, which would be very amazing with Jaina, which TCM Gaming, of course, knows as well. But, yeah, the draft is starting, and I'm pretty happy that we have a game on Towers of Doom.
Yeah, Jaina ban definitely expected from TCM here. But they now get their opportunity to bring out maybe another frontliner, seeing as Euronics have yet to pick any of those yet. But they can get a lot of control that way.
Yeah, one of the things that I want to see is, you remember when we saw the game actually played between NaVi and Euronics? NaVi banned out the Lost Vikings. And that was one of the things, maybe they had some bad experience with like Towers of Doom in general and just banned it out. Or they actually saw Euronics play with the Vikings at some point during a scrim. So if TCM doesn't ban them out, I'm actually a bit curious if Euronics would really go for a Viking play here, because I have not seen the Vikings on Towers of Doom yet, so I would enjoy that.
Yeah, I would agree. I am a huge fan of the Vikings, especially seeing as they're my highest win rate hero. That StarCraft experience hype. But I've not really seen them played that often on this map. So I'd be very excited to see them being brought out here.
Nika again with Zagara here, so they lock her down again. They played a lot with also, well, Sonya, for example. So TCM is actually like starting to draft a very similar composition to what we've seen in the last two games from them here. With the next draft here, they could go into, they have so many choices right now. You could go into a Tassadar, you could start with one of your very strong tanks at the front line then once again. So they have actually like quite a few choices, and it is the ETC. They take ETC, one of the tanks here. Tassadar would have been an option, could have gone into an early Sonya here. Euronics, right away, they ban out Uther, saying like, Divine Shielded Mosh Pit not going to happen against us. And now TCM Gaming, is it going to be that Jaina ban, or are we going to see something else? And if the Vikings are not going to be banned, will Euronics take them? NaVi banned them out against Euronics earlier on. Was that something that they had more information than we did, or were they just afraid of going up against a split hero like the Vikings on Towers of Doom in general? So that's what I'm a bit excited about. And yeah, Jaina is being banned. That made a whole lot of sense, of course.
Yeah, it would be very weird for them not to, just due to the huge burst combo that Euronics would get. The Vikings being picked here for Euronics, I do still like it. There's Tassadar being picked, but they would be running Vikings into a Kael'thas. And Chain Bomb is a wonderful, wonderful thing.
Yeah, but a good Vikings player, like I had actually like a big discussion with Vortex about this at some point, and he said that a good Vikings player is always going to wait with his jump until the Chain Bombs are in and will be able to dodge that. So there's the argument against picking Vikings into a Kel'Thas, and then you have a lot of players that are saying, hey, if you play it right, you should be able to deal with that. So yeah, there's a lot of back and forth happening.
Like, I quite like running Vikings into Kel'Thas due to the fact that if you can spread the Chain Bombs to just the Vikings and keep them alive with jump, then you've just blocked Chain Bomb from spreading to the rest of your team.
Well, I personally think that with the setup that we're seeing now, the Vikings option is a little bit less likely.
Yeah.
Doesn't really make as much sense anymore. We have that Tassadar-Tyrande composition, again, that Euronics played before. And we also have the Sonya Muradin. So this is a pretty sick setup, actually. I kind of like what they are drafting here. They still need a bit of range damage. Reyna would be a choice. Vala could be also a good pick for them. TCM Gaming, I mean, they can really argue, you can argue a bit about what they should go for here. But we have the opportunity for them, for example, to head into another tank as well. You could go into a Leoric if you wanted to. You could go into a Johanna at this point. Or you can just like go straight up for more damage if you really wanted to. They have already a double damage in the back, good control on the map, thanks to Zagara, ETC, and Karazim. So another melee hero might maybe not be a bad choice, but you could also go for the full damage version here if you really wanted to do that. Ah, Tyrael. That, of course, makes sense as well.
Yeah, I don't know why, but into most of those.
Tyrael actually slips my mind these days quite a bit.
Yeah, considering like the fact is he hasn't really been changed since BlizzCon, where he was really dominant. But he is still very effective, but he just isn't picked as much in the meta because he's a warrior without stun, really.
And there's the Reyna. Okay, so this is basically like a more of a normal draft that we're seeing right now, and I pretty much expect. I like the Tyrael choice here, by the way. And Tyrael, for like quite often, has also been chosen with ETC. I mean, we are always talking about the Divine Shield into Moshpit, but Sanctification into Moshpit can be pretty nasty as well. So that has been for a long time, so to say, the poor man's Divine Shield when you are playing with the Moshpit. It's true. Oftentimes, when you get denied that Uther, that Tyrael was an option.
Yeah, it's the communism back. Divine Shield. Not quite as effective, but spread amongst everyone.
I probably wouldn't have put it that way, but all right.
It's not quite as effective, but it's spread amongst everyone.
Okay, Tyrael is a communist, confirmed. TCM is going up against Euronics game number 3, guys, and this is the deciding map between the two teams, so let's find out which team is going to win the series and advances with NaVi to the next round of the tournament. All right, boys, the last game of the day, boys and girls, we have Towers of Doom, and it is TCM versus Euronics, and this is, of course, the map choice of Euronics again. And at this point, as you can already see, we're currently looking at Ace of Spades on Karazim to the left side of the map. We have Danatan on ETC, Devis on Kel'Thas, Remabala on Tyrael, and Nika on Zagara again. To the right side of the map, we have Krollo on Tyrael, the Polish team here with the map choice, Gluehammer on Muradin, Kreku on Reyna, Uberim on Sonya, and Tassadar is playing Zhuv. Actually, it's the other way around. Zhuv is playing Tassadar, but well. And yeah, we already saw a pretty crazy game on Towers of Doom earlier, where NaVi played against Euronics, and they chose the same map again. And this is going to be the final one. Whoever wins here is going to advance with NaVi to the round of 8, and the team that loses is out of the tournament.
Very excited to see this. We're seeing an Owl build once again coming in for Toronto. Zagara pretty much just saw everyone setting up for the kill there, but we're not actually seeing any first bloods coming out right now. Both teams just clearing the minion waves. Actually, going on to ETC, and he's gone.
And Euronics, they do it again. Like, this has this theme for every single game that we cast it of these boys. At the beginning of the game, they get a kill.
Like, first you might blood as well, masters.
Yeah, you might as well just run a hero to the right side and sacrifice yourself to get it over with, because it's going to happen anyways.
Well, one of us has to do it. Just pick Murky just to guarantee that they get first one. It doesn't matter as much.
Exactly. Like, just run one over and being like, all right, I'll take one for the team. Bam.
I volunteer as tribute.
Well, for now, we have, in terms of talents, as you already said, the Owl build is, of course, going to help with the cooldown reduction thanks to the Empower. It's a great build for any map if you are playing as a solo healer on the team with Tyrande, but of course, now we have a Tyrande-Tassadar composition. One of the main reasons why you will also go for this build here is because you can, with Pierce, then interrupt easily the channel on the altars, and that is very, very important here. It's very reminiscent of what you would do when you are playing on Cursed Hollow or on Blackheart's Bay when you want to go for the channel interrupts as well. The first altar is already spawning, and of course with that we're going to see the teams move in fairly soon. Bottom lane, that's where most of the action is happening. And talking about action happening, there's lockdown against Zagara and kill number 2 for Team Euronics.
Euronics is way too good at this. Although, bit of revenge there coming in for the side of TCM. They're able to pick up Reyna in the top lane. Uberim though, already able to move back up to the top lane and begin soaking the XP, so they don't miss out on too much. And they have so much control, they are just easily going to be able to take control of this tower. Ace of Spades, not having it, but he's kind of walked into a really tough position here. Matches to dodge the stun, still taking damage, dashes to Kael'thas, and he will escape.
If Danton, he would not have dodged that stun, he would have been dead.
Yeah.
Well, for now, they're actually moving in again. It's now 5 versus 5. Not yet, though, and we have Krollo being attacked before the battle even starts, and he is already down. Finally, Uberim is here. But yeah, that action of Ace of Spades actually secured them the altar.
Yeah,
he nearly
risky.
Died doing it, but thanks to that, they are able to get the first few shots fired against the opponent's core.
It was risky, but definitely worth. Well, very well played by Ace there.
That was very risky. I mean, he nearly died. If he doesn't dodge that stun, if that stun is a bit closer to home, then it's all over. Well, with the first altar, he's going to die and they are going to get the shots as well. They're going to be even farther behind. But as is, they are now slightly ahead when it comes to the points on the core. And they also have really closed that slight gap in experience that we saw after these two initial kills against TCM.
Yeah, and the fact TCM were able to get control of that tower as well means they're really evening everything up. And right now, roaming up to the top lane, they're going to find the Roaming Gank Squad of they're going to find Euronics Roaming Gank Squad here. Devis gets shielded by Tyrael, but still gets picked off. In comes ETC, though, for the revenge kill. But so many members of Euronics have come up here. They're able to push back ETC, not able to get a second kill. But that was a very nice kill secure. Kael Fass roaming up to top lane, just like, let's help gank Tyrael. Then it was like, oh god, the gank squad's already here.
If you are Tyrael, if you are Kael Fass, then you just hate your life at that moment.
Oh yeah.
Like, you just walk in and suddenly...
in general, you hate your life till 13.
Yeah, kind of. But then everybody else hates you, so that even...
Yeah, exactly.
Level 7 talent, slightly faster, and we have now Luna Blaze taken. We're also seeing, of course, Piercing Bolt, Ferocious Healing, Kala's Embrace, a lot of heals actually, a lot of abilities to really keep the team alive. Question is really what we're going to see on level 13 for Taranda.
Oh, Glue Hammer! Mistakes were made!
They go through the wall,
He's dying, the stun! Hunter killer! Oh, it expires, very close.
Yeah, but somebody else is dying, and that is Ubarim at the top lane. Sonya is down. Has been eliminated. Yep, well done here. Fission Bomb now, so level 7 versus level 7 talents once again. And on level 7 we also see Just Keep Rocking. We have the Fission Bombs. Again, of course, duh. What else? Rapid Incubation for Zagara, the talent for Nika. We've been talking about it. The Echo of Heaven and Tyrael is most likely going to go for the Babel Momentum here. Whereas we have the two altars now ready and both of the teams are fighting for them.
Zagara not coming up yet, though she is on her way now, but she is very late here. Remember Baller thinking about to die, decides against it instead. Just going to see a clean tower trade. Neither team want to take the risk.
Yeah, so first of all, we have a couple of shots fired here to the left, to the right. And now we're down to 32 versus 36 overall. So overall, I mean, we have like 3 kills versus 3 kills. It's a fairly even game. We have a slight lead, of course, for TCM in terms of hit points on the core, but that's already about it. And it's all about just rotations on the map. We had Euronics starting things off with the usual strong rotation that they have, taking down targets. But then we saw the exact same thing happening at the top, where two times Sonya was already taken out. Battle Momentum, as expected, has by now been taken on Tyrael. And he is under a bit of pressure there, but we also see the pressure play at the bot lane, where we have four heroes starting to push in the wall. And Kraku is, of course, going to have a very tough time defending against that solo as he is, and therefore Roof is starting to move in and helping out there.
We are seeing TCM picking that off, but it is kind of base race for Remember Baller. Just defending this as best he can. Shielding the minions is actually very effective at preventing this kind of push from happening, but he is still very outnumbered. Down goes Reyna, getting caught out of position a bit there.
Yeah, Reyna at the bot lane falling, and this is starting to look better and better for TCM. The beginning of the game was definitely not in their favor, but right now it's actually looking very solid. They are starting to get a bit closer to level 10, maybe even a bit ahead there. 4 kills against 3, a slight lead in terms of core hit points too. Not by any means a lead that they can capitalize on in the sense that they can go straight for a kill or maybe win the game, but right now they also took one of those towers, which has to be eliminated first. So I really like the way that they are playing this at this point. They had a bit of a rough start into the game, but they are really starting to find their pace.
Yeah, definitely agree. They're really taking a good amount of control here. The Phoenix being used as push. TCM annihilating pretty much all the buildings on the map for now. Gloomhammer, very aggressive considering his team is not yet here, and yep, that's what I thought would happen. I was like, let me go in before my team gets here.
They are slipping a little bit. Really, like, one of the biggest things about them were their coordination at the start of the game and when they really coordinated all of their attacks quite well. But right now, they start to slip a bit. First, a kill against Kraku at the bot lane on Reyna, then now suddenly Meridin dying there in a very similar situation. So stuff like that should really happen to them. We have more camps taken on the map, and Alta is ready at the bottom, and they don't even go for it. They're just saying, hey, we need to soak experience. Reyna's up at the top, he doesn't even rotate, doesn't even try to. He was just like getting the experience here and trying to hold it. But now we have, of course, everything just like shots fired once again. Nice position here for them, and at the bot lane it's a 4 versus 4 situation with TCM going in for this right away and trying, of course, to defend them.
Yeah, the shields from Tacit are trying to protect this fort as much as possible. Danatan just looking for any opportunity to engage with his team, but doesn't want to get called out. Backing up, Team Already Mounted and Tyrael has already left the lane, so not willing to take the risk of getting called out here.
Yeah, and well, talking about like Tyrael is actually playing this pretty safe as well, just staying in the back on his mount, just soaking experience, not much more than that. We have down to the bottom of the map, Gluehammer, Krolu, and Juuf in position at this point. All of them just basically ready, trying to maybe to get a kill somewhere, and it's always like that Tyrael composition that they're of course aiming for, but they don't get that kill because TCM is currently doing a very solid job at moving as a closed unit across the map. They have maybe Tyrael somewhere else, but he's the hero in the lineup that has the best escapes next to Karazim. So yeah, they're playing a very, very controlled game at this point, I want to say. And again! Isolated and taken down.
Yeah, Murdered, He's kind of doing his job by frontlining, but there's a difference between frontlining and going all the way, going that far forward and getting caught. You do need to coordinate with your team a bit, but they don't want to stay grouped because they don't want to get caught and moshed. It's a very bad quandary for him.
And TCM is playing it perfectly right now. They get a kill, they take a tower. They get a kill, they take a tower. They move back, they take a camp. They are always in a situation where they are slightly ahead because of these small moves that they make, these small things where they capitalize on a kill that they get, on an auto that they can snipe, on a rotation on the map. And it really works well for them. We have now Euronics trying to counter that, but also going for pushes up at the top, as you can see. But there's already Rema Baller trying to just like push them back a bit and help out. And the rest of the team is rotating in too. There's Altas announced on the map, but that's 20 seconds. And if they get a kill or two up at the top, that would be totally worth it.
There's the mosh onto Raider. Seven-sided strike, and he is deleted. To Ronda, trying to be on the run. Sonya has just ditched him and has run down towards the Altas to try and grab those. And we're going to see the Ronda go down here. And TCM will rush down there, but they might be too soon. Tastar Force Wall did it.
was close. But yeah, they're going to get both of these towers. They have five. Actually, like only one. One was captured by Meridian at the bot lane, but it's still five shots against three. So the situation for them is actually very solid now. 23 against 33. And they move in again. They want to go for Uberim. And it's just like, right now, it's really scary to see how TCM is controlling this game. And at the beginning, it looked like it would be exactly the opposite. TCM was the one getting slaughtered. Well, not really slaughtered. I mean, they lost two heroes. They started to lose out on experience. But that comeback that they have here, they just played nearly perfectly at this point.
Yeah, Destiny seems to be a theme with Euronics. They have a huge early game control, but then they seem to let it slip every now and again. And this could be an experience thing, but they could still win this. They're definitely not out of this yet, but I can't wait to see them play in the future as well, when they've got a bit more coordinated and have calmed down a bit.
Yeah, the chain bombs are now here. Imposing Will has of course been chosen on level 13, but again, that bottom had to be fought, like they had to recapture that. Now they have to recapture the mid lane, and that just costs time. It's more time thing than anything else. Like, they have to dedicate heroes to go into the middle, take down the tower here. At the same time, it opens up an opportunity for them to go to the top. If those mercenaries... Nah, they go for the kill. Okay, so they take the structure. But yeah, this is just a very uncomfortable position for Euronics because they are reacting the entire time to what TCM does, and it allows TCM to get farther and farther ahead in experience, and that is going to result in a level 16 talent when they start to fight over these two altars at the top, and could potentially also end up in them getting an even bigger lead in core damage.
Yeah, this is very much the case. But they're first going to just use this opportunity to grab the mercenaries. Both of the forts are alive, so these are... The sappers only going to be pushing onto the forts, and the top one also going to be taken back, so they're not going to get any extra shots onto the core if TCM are able to grab both. But Euronics are actually going to make a play onto the row one. Tyrael is grabbing the one further back, so they're just not risking dying all-inning on Euronics one. Instead, they secure one, they're able to stay safe at Euronics one, and move in for the fight. Meridian getting a good start, good forceful to separate the team, but the Sanctification and the Moor able to protect the rest of TCM. They're looking ready to move in. We've already lost Raider, and we're going to see Tassadar escape. No.
Yeah,
there he goes.
No way. Ace jumps in and takes him. And I mean, this is another four shots that are going to be fired here. And they had the level 16 talent, which was, of course, one of their biggest assets during that fight. They have still not captured it because apparently they're trying to take now one of the altars as well. They leave ETC to make sure that he can guard this for now. And they are actually trying to time it, aren't they? No, okay, yeah, they gave up on the idea. I guess it was the original idea to try it, but then they realized that it wouldn't really
They might happen. Be able to, actually. Yeah. Oh, no, he did it.
No, they take it.
Yeah, they would have been able to do that, actually, if they had waited, but they decided against it, not willing to take the risk.
And, I mean, I don't really blame them for that. It's one point on the core. I feel like it was worth taking it a bit earlier. In the end, yes, they could have done it, but still. For now, we have Ranger taken. We see Stoneform, Bullseye, Nerves of Steel, and the Dimensional Warp. I feel this is really the best chance for Euronics to fight back, like, now. They have already the altar in the mid lane that they need to take. It's going to cost them some time to also eliminate the one up at the top to put it into a 4v4 situation again. But I feel like this is the best time that they have to actually try and bring it back with a good team fight.
Yeah, there is also the fact that TCM do have Nicker on their team, an XG2 player, and G2 very well known for their boss throws. So there's still always the potential of that happening a bit later on. Euronics were able to throw themselves a little bit earlier as well, TCM. There's still that potential, but they're making the correct decision on this map of not risking it unless literally everyone is dead.
I mean, again, we're in a situation where they have, like, they took the altar tower in the mid lane. They had to move to the top, claim the top tower back. Now they have to move down to the bottom lane. Guess what's going to happen? In the meantime, we're going to see more camps taken. Then they can rotate into the mid lane again, can try to take that, maybe get a kill. Like, TCM is playing this perfectly. Always in the... Like, they're always moving on the map. Never really standing still. Never pushing something too much. Now they go for... Tassadar.
Oh,
they can't get
nice.
The kill.
Oh, the turn.
Is the chance? Good. Maybe? Oh, good mark.
Nika lived. Nice use of the healing ward there. Nika gonna escape here. And no one died on either team there. Euronics, very nice sustain throughout that.
Yeah, and still that tower down to the bot lane. I mean, we have two towers. This one is extremely low in hit points, can be taken at any moment. At the bottom, this one has already been claimed. Now they're fighting over the altar again. This is just a trick. It's such a devastating situation for Euronics. TCM is doing so well here. 33 points on the core against 15. It's incredible how far ahead they are right now.
TTC does have Mort, but if they kill him off early, then it's not going to be that useful. There is the Shadowstalk to protect Euronics from the extra damage here. Rememberballer, not in the great position. He's separate from his team here. Maybe he wants to try and use Holy Ground to zone some heroes out so his team can go for the kill. Ace, once again, going in for the denial, but he's completely alone here, getting focused down, and he gets picked off. In comes TTC, gets the Mort, catches a lot of members here, and they're going to be able to take down at least one of them. Bluehammer getting focused, is able to dwarf toss away. Tyrael was looking for the chase, but ETC taken down. Nicker and Davis trying to be careful. They turn onto Kraku. So does Rememberballer, but he's not able to land that Holy Ground in the right position. Force Wall trapping Chaos that's inside. He bops the Arcane Barrier, keeping himself alive. And Tassadar, with the Dimensional Warp, is able to get himself out as well. And both teams are running away, and they're just going to leave the tower there.
Yeah, Bluehammer can go in again. I mean, his trade kicked in, and they are going to get that eventually, I feel. But still, even if they do, they only get three shots fired, and that's it. That's not really a whole lot. And Rema Bola's already starting to move back again, stunned here, but still, even with that, the Holy Ground is helping him a lot. And there's
Ooh,
more. That altar is still active. The altar is still active at this point, and we have Kel'Thas back to full health and mana. 7 seconds until Karazim is back, but I think this time they will find
It looks like they're finally giving up. Kel'Thas has run to top, so he's going to be able to clear up that, just make sure that they can get a bit more pressure on. And it's only three shots, only three available to them, because they still weren't able to take down that bottom fort.
Yeah, Ace just went a bit too deep there. He was really feeling the pressure and needed to go in to interrupt the channel. But of course, he was very much exposed then. And that's maybe the time that they needed to come back into this. But of course, as already predicted earlier, the mid lane can easily be taken at any moment in time. That's also the level 20 that is now being dropped into the hands of TCM. And we have, again, Transgression taken. Mosh pit, actually, on level 20 with Death Metal. And they go for the boss.
The
owl is there.
This
is it. This could be the moment, but boss is gonna be taken. It's too late.
Oh, they're not gonna risk it.
Yeah, shots are fired.
Yeah, shots fired. That's 4 damage onto the core, bringing the core down to 11.
You can't go in there. Like, Mirrodin was the only one that was at the front. If he jumps in, Transgression is used and he's instantly dead.
Yeah, he will just get annihilated. So for now, TCM just throwing around their dominance, taking another fort. But the punishment is looking to come down, and this is exactly what you said might happen, but he tanks it with that hardened shield, actually. The force wall separating out a lot of heroes. They're trying to get Danaton and take him down. Espe using some nice dashes to get away and help his team escape. Pasta chasing forwards with Dimensional Warp, actually. They found Zagara a bit away, but Zagara was able to blink out of range, and everyone's able to live again.
Yeah, now it's 20 versus 20 with three altars on the map, and with... like, if all three are channeled, then it's a win right here for TCM. If they get all three, it's a win immediately for them. But even if only two are taken, then we would see Euronics down on two. Once again, they are starting to move in, and at this point, we have Nexus Frenzy, of course, taken for Reyna. It's a massive amount of damage that he has right now. If he can bring that into the fight, it would be amazing for them. Double Hardened Shield, Rewind on Tyrande. There's a lot of potential here, but the channel up at the top, Davis is going to go for it, and he's going to get the first five-point channel. It's a lot of damage down here. We have a counter channel, points are fired, we have 7 points on the hook. Blue Hammer is going to take one, that's three, but they're already up at the top here, where we have Kreku, and he's trying to just like push Ace back, and he does. 27 against 6, Euronics is moving in, so is TCM, they're going for it, they snipe against Zagara. Transgression once again used, but not killing anybody here, and this is the opportunity that Euronics was waiting for the entire time. ETC mosh pit against 3, but stunned out by Ubereem's Mystical Spear. Once again, Danatan on the run, they can get him, they take him down, it's a double kill already, and this is the chance for Euronics to turn the game maybe around and finally start a comeback, but it's 27 core points against 6. I'm not sure if it might already be too late here.
Well, that's not going to stop them trying. They're throwing everything they have at it. They've actually left that tower unattended if a Kerosene or Chaos wanted to run up there, but they're not going to take the risk. Instead, we're seeing Euronics getting as many of the forts as possible so that when they grab that tower, then they're going to be in a bit of a better position. However, TCM looking to maybe counter that by going for that bottom fort to try and reduce the amount of shots got. We can see the Euronics delaying this as long as possible so that they can get at least that top fort back. And Karasim and Kael, that's not enough to take the bottom one.
They want to have 5, and they're going to get it. They're going to get those 5. It's 1 second on Zagara, 14 on ETC. I don't think they can delay for this long, but they're going to get 5 shots fired in now. That's going to help them. It's going to be 22 to 6 points on the core, but still, it's of course super tricky right now. One team fight that you lose, one big fight, and it could be the end of you. For now, we're having camps taken everywhere on the map again. For now, it was actually like in this case, CCM that took the camps down here at the bottom because they said like, well, we can't really do anything else. We can't go for a tower. Let's at least take a camp or two. And in the mid lane now, the pressure play, there's still towers around that he can take down. It's also a bit of experience, but also, of course, a little bit of a safety net that we're still seeing here for the opponent. Ranger is starting to do some damage. Good Phoenix. And yeah, Gloohammer spreading the damage, passing the chain bombs onto Kreku. Both of the teams have to be super careful now because, yeah, TCM is super far ahead, but still, games can be turned.
Yeah, very much so, and it could even be turned by Euronics going in here because, for one thing, Danaton has Death Metal, not the Torbus here, so he can turn it even if he dives in, giving his own life to try and win the game that way.
Yeah, also the boss is going to be up in another minute, which is also going to be important. So boss could be another thing that is going to play a factor here. But, well, for now, the fight is once again starting. Zoning happening, first of all, with the Force Wall, but also with the Holy Ground.
Yeah, Mosh is up, available for Danaton. Getting stunned up, getting focused down. It gets away this time, so he might be willing to turn around and go back in with that Mosh bit. Even if he died, Death Metal is there, but it doesn't mean you want to die on purpose just to get the Mosh off.
Yeah, so Hyperion, like a lot of the cooldowns have actually been committed to this, and especially on the side of Euronics. They start to take a few of the camps again, and they take those as we speak. We still have the mosh pit ready. Juve is kind of low. There comes again Tyrael with the Sanctification. Gloohammer popping already. Stone form after Avatar. Oh. And here comes the mosh pit. And where's the interrupt? Oh my god, Mirrodin actually walked in instead of interrupting it. And Reyna is dead now. This is TCM's chance to maybe end the game. Kroll is about to die. They can take one more hero down. The alt at the bot lane has spawned. Oh wow, and they go straight for the potential kill here at the top again against Mirrodin. Great healing ward too. Everybody jumping out. Ace trying again with the transgression, not getting the kill though, but they still have the 5v4 advantage on the map.
Yeah, there is a temple available. There's a tower available. There's a boss available. Gloohammer going very deep, considering how much health he has. In comes Ubereem as well. And they're having to back up more hits. No one but Mirrodin is already dead. TCM turning this around. Ubereem getting focused out. He's got so many shields, though. Just does not die, but they've lost two members, and Kael'thas not even bothering to help with this. He's just running straight down to bot to grab control of that tower. Will not be enough to end the game, but it will move them either one tower or one boss away from ending the game.
Exactly. A boss would be all that they need, and that, of course, is then a huge risk now in general.
Not quite, but still.
Like, that threat of a boss finishing the game is absolutely insane at this point. Like, because you know that whenever there is... Let's say, for example, there's an altar again at the bottom of the map. What are you going to do? Are you going to go for the altar? Are you going to try to defend the boss? Because one way or another, your opponent might be able to kill to end the game. And, boss actually triggered at this point.
They go for it.
They have 10 seconds for Muradin. They actually try to end it. That might be a bit ballsy here.
Yeah, they go for it. They're taking a lot of damage. This boss is very deadly. He does a lot of damage here. ETC still has 13 seconds for his Mosh to come back. And Euronics able to drive back TCM. But TCM, all they have to do is to be patient, not throw, and wait. All they need is one tower there.
Yeah. Imagine, for example, a triple altar happening. Like, that would be the worst case scenario.
That would suck.
And Euronics is just saying, hey, we have to go out on the map. We have to, be in the opponent's face right now. It might be risky, but we have to be out there. We can't sit back and wait and react. We need to dominate the map now, or we are going to have problems. Tyrael never died here. Once again, the fight is happening. Hyperion is already in play. We have Transgression being used, and the kill against Tyrael. This is Euronics, maybe, with a bit of a turnaround, trying to go for the stun. The Maw is saving them, and it's still a 5 versus 4. A lead for Euronics now with numbers, but still, it's only one altar. It's a triple.
It's a triple altar. They need to split it. They can't group for this. They can't afford to.
Oh my god.
TCM, staying together, looking for their opportunity.
They are down still. They are down a player.
All they need is one. You can see at the bot lane, they're all being split up and guarded.
They have Tyrande. They can interrupt. They're everywhere. They're starting to channel. They're going for the channels.
They're all going to bot except for Kael'thas, who is going for that top one. He is actually just going to do a lot of damage to Sonya, but Tyrande is still here. Like you said, they're just delaying. Raider will grab this one. That is guaranteed. Muradin on his own just delaying this. Their transgression does a lot of damage.
Yeah, they go in. First one has been channeled. They get 4 shots in. Tyrael is going to be back very soon up at the top now. Bit of a pressure play. Kreku is in. They try to go for Nika.
Nice bolt again.
That was a point with the last second.
Gloomhammer still delaying this. Top one's been left unattended. They really need to get back up there and defend that. Raider arriving down to chase off Danitan.
Yeah, top lane as well. Phoenix in play again. Bot lane. There's only Gloomhammer against Danitan. Nothing else. 4 versus 4 at the top. But Euronics is low. They're really low hit points.
Kroku is killing off Nika here, doing a lot of damage. Probably coming back here. Sorry, Kroku. Remember Baller coming in to try and do as much as he can. Even if he explodes, it's more damage. There's the sack to block out at least some of the Hyperion damage. Tassadar's arrived. And Muradin has actually chased ETC away from the turning point here. Danitan realizes he can't win that fight. And it looks like Muradin is going to try and turn in that one. Whereas the rest of Euronics still delaying this alpha style just to make sure.
Once again, the bottom lane is being attacked. Gloomhammer is all alone. Gloomhammer is alone. They need to rotate in and help him. Oh, the mosh pit is being used. They're trying to just snipe one hero. It's all that they need to do. They go for it. But here's the Avatar. He actually survives long enough. I can't believe that they're still in this game.
Still holding. Top lane's under contention as well. All was used.
My God.
But it didn't hit anyone. Ace being chased off. Joom is taking a lot of damage here. Needs to be careful. Kreku backing up. Gloomhammer also dropping low here. Danitan moving in, just trying to push him back, and Remoler trying to turn in.
No! Muradin is dead, and this could be the end. Channel at the top, but here comes the owl, interrupting him once again. Up at the top, we're seeing at the same time Juve trying to go for the altar again, but the roaches are everywhere, interrupting him once more. Krolu and Kriku at the bottom. Netherwind doesn't hit. Danitan is low. Kriku, the kill against this is it. Kill against Reyna and against Tyrande.
Tassadar
is just rushing away. The shots are fired at the top, but this one is going to be channeled eventually. It's only Sonya.
Sonya alone can make it. Come at me, bros. Well, wins in. He's delaying. There's the sack. They can just cap in the sack. You're invulnerable. Uberim coming back in. Gets stunned up. Falls forward. Doesn't he hit? Runnable is still delaying, but he's gone down. And that is going to be GG.
Oh, wow. So they get the game. They are able to win it. Really well done here. And of course, very sad for Euronics after a great showing today. They are out of the tournament. TCM advances together with NaVi after an incredible best of three series in a consolation match. GG, congratulations and well played.
Okay, everybody, that's it for the day. We had some really fun games here, and I hope that you enjoyed them and also the commentary. Of course, we're going to have more Heroes of the Storm action on the channel in the near future. So if you enjoy the esports scene, Heroes of the Storm, make sure that you hit that subscribe button on Khaldor TV and also like the video if you haven't done that yet already. There's going to be more European games. We're going to have more North American matches as well. And of course, if you're interested in the Chinese Heroes of the Storm esports scene, I'm going to have more games on the channel as well in the near future as those leagues start again. At the same time, though, if you have friends that are also interested in esports and in Heroes of the Storm, make sure that you forward the channel to them and share it with them. It was a pleasure casting for you today, guys. I hope that you enjoyed, as I already mentioned, and I hope to see you next time for more Heroes of the Storm action here on Khaldor TV. See you guys soon. Have a great day. Bye-bye.